Hey everyone, PincheAls here, and today we're going to do a full breakdown of the Royal Enfield Interceptor 650, the 2022 model. So let's get to work, because this is PincheAls Garage. Now, what do we mean by breakdown? We're going to give you guys a general idea where everything is located on this bike. That way, if you guys ever need to point at something or understand where something belongs, you know what it's called and know where it actually goes. So, we're going to give you guys a whole breakdown from front all over to the back. So, let's get to work. So, as we're going to go to the front, we have our general placement for our headlight. Okay, this is like nothing special. Left and right turn signals, our suspension, the fork, our front fender. If we go down here, we got our front disc and our caliper here. The two bolts here that hold the caliper. We got the one axle right here that's just actually what holds the wheel in place. If we work our way up, we're gonna go to our instrument cluster. Now we got our tack and our speedometer. We have a basic gauge here that gives us pretty much fuel, mileage, and that's pretty much it, nothing special. If we work our way forward, obviously the handlebars. On this bike, I do have heated grips that I installed, but we're not gonna worry about that. We get the master cylinder, front brakes, over to the left. We got our clutch, which is cable driven. The brakes are hydraulic, low beam, high beam, turn signals, horn. Over here, our starter, our hard on and off, ignition. That's it. Oh, got this little button here that helps you reset the mileage on the bike as well. That's pretty much the front end on the bike. Now, as we work our way one step back, right here with a gas tank, obviously we have our gas tank. We go down, we have here is the next part. So now we have our oil cooler with the grill, little rock chip grill here. If you see here, if we work our way over to the right, we have the two horns, left and right. We have our exhaust. They're identical on the left and right with the O2 sensors here. So remember that, guys. Your O2 sensors sit right at the base of the head. So very, very important. Okay. So your exhaust goes all the way down to the slip-on mufflers here. If we work our way back up, you have your valve cover. You'll notice here up close, there's a gasket in between these two. So very important. This is not decorative. This is actually a valve cover that has to come off to give you access to the valves. You have your spark plug wire, and obviously the spark plug, the head, the block, and the bottom portion of the transmission. That is the basic assembly here. We move over to the right. Now, I'm showing you what is accessible from this point of the part of the bike. There's the fuel injector. This is like an intake cover. This is the actual intake. Throttle body sits underneath it. If we work our way down, this is the first case. This gives you access to the actual transmission. This is a 6-speed slip disc transmission. This gives you full access to the clutch if you ever need to do clutch work on this side. The clutch on this, again, is manual, so it's 6-speed. This is your adjustment here for your clutch lever. This is your actual clutch lever, your peg. If you need to ever replace the starter on this bike, it sits right here on this little top cover. Actually, no, I'm sorry. To the left. This is the starter right here. So not the one on the right, the left. Now we're gonna work our way over to the further right. This is just a cover. This doesn't have much anything important yet. We'll show you guys when we get to that point. We're gonna work our way over to the right. We got our preload shocks here, our slip-on exhaust, the rear passenger peg. Down here we have our chain. Our chain goes all the way over to the rear axle, and this is where you guys do your adjustments for your chain, and you obviously got to get your proper tool to put the proper tension for the chain. This is where it's all done here. You got your chain cover or your guide. Rear wheel. Work our way to the back. The bootay. You have your brake light, left and right turn signal. The rear fender. Move over to the right. Now we have our rear disc brake, caliper, the other shock, obviously the rest of the exhaust system, the other passenger peg. Now this piece right here, don't worry about this. This came from the dealer. This is just a battery tender. If you're gonna leave your bike, not use it for so long, this is what's gonna keep the battery charged. This is the brake fluid reservoir for the rear brake. And on over here, the brake master cylinder actually sits right here for the rear. Okay, this is the other peg and your rear brake lever right here. If you go up, this is the cover. This is the actual cover, gives you full access to the fuse box and everything else underneath, behind this, especially underneath the seat. And we'll show you guys that after this portion. As we work our way over again to the right, same exact thing on the other side, like the other side, intake cover, fuel injector. These two are actually the throttle cables. Intake, throttle body, fuel injector right there. The other spark plug cable, spark plug. Everything's the same. Again, identical from left to right. Now, the little things that change over here, obviously. You got your oil fill right here. You have your clutch lever mechanism right here. This is pretty much for your clutch up here. This is a brake. Clutch on that side. This is what actually disengages and engages the clutch itself. With the adjustment over here, the other horn, and obviously we're back to the oil cooler. Down over here on the actual bottom case of the cover, there's your visual oil fill. So this gives you a visual representation of pretty much how much oil's in the bike. We work our way over. Here, we're gonna have our oil filter. Now, that's pretty much the entirety of everything that's like immediate that you can see exterior-wise on the bike. Now, in the next video, we're gonna give you guys a full breakdown when we start taking things apart, okay? I'm not gonna remove the gas tank. I don't wanna remove the gas tank, but I will remove the side covers, the seat for you guys. And give you guys a breakdown of the electrical system and pretty much on how to remove certain things as well. But that's pretty much a quick rundown about this bike. We'll show you guys on the next video about tearing apart the back end of this guy. See you guys next time.